about your own experience with being in a plant-based diet. So how did it start for you?
Basically, as I've said, I usually drop the labels. But when you ask me, when people ask me, I'm on a primarily plant-based diet.
Yeah.
I eat more plants than other things.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Because some people have their own triggers, like their own reasons why they start doing it. I'm not plant-based, but I eat more plants than I do meats. But why is it? For me, it's my gut issues. But what was it for
mine
you?
Mine really started at home. Mm-hmm. I used to have graders, school kids. So that's how it basically began. In my home kitchen, I'd juice for them every day, just so they'd avoid canned or junk from the canteen.
Yes.
So every day I do this so passionately and take out my juicer every night when everybody else was asleep, you know, wash all the vegetables and make juice for them so that when they wake up in the morning, they'd have that.
Yes.
So I started with, you know, the citrus, citrus fruits like orange, carrots, and just to replace the boxed orange juice. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So very simple intentions, just to have something healthy for
and
the family.
And that's how, it's just one thing you did
it's just
to
that,
start, yeah.
Right? And basically it's really just to feed the family a healthier options.
Yes.
The only reason really why we were also selling for friends or for neighbors is because that's what we were having in the house.
Yeah.
And there'd be extra bowls, so we'd sell it. But yeah, you were asking what triggers or my purpose
in doing this is
really family.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So it was really just to eat better for your family, and then it just grew into a business. What was the first one that you started?
Oh, this was the one that we had 10 years ago. That was 2014. It's a very little store, and I didn't have any plans of making this into anything like this.
Yes.
Nothing was ever premeditated for us. Basically, it's just because orders were filling our kitchen already up until our living room. My husband wanted to look for a space already for us. He signed the lease space for us, and we put up that little store. We call it Soul Kitchen Grab and Go. Mm-hmm. And that's how we began.
That's the first one. And
that's
now
the first
one. I mean, this is 10 years ago, and now you have how many brands under?
We have four food brands under my name. We're a family corporation now, and we're around six locations in Davao.
What can you say about those that say, oh, you know, it's vegetables, it's not.
I know.
You know, they have this idea that it can't be as flavorful. As you mentioned, it's flavorful. How do you change that mindset? That's the thing that I think you need to overcome to be able to cross over to the green side, to that side. How do you do that? How are you convincing people slowly? Because it's growing in Davao.
For me, it's just really by making plates and good dishes out of this.
Yeah.
Food is always the way to everybody's.
Yeah.
How do we say that? Everybody's heart?
Yeah.
No.
Food is always
the way to communicate something.
Yeah, and it's also healing. It can be healing. It doesn't just have to be, I feel like.
But I think if we just drop the, you know, that you were saying, we just drop the lecture part of it, the preaching part of it, then we just enjoy vegetables as a dish that's worthy to be enjoyed, then I think the fun part of vegetable comes in.
I mean, I remember because my mom would tell me, eat your veggies. And when my mom used to tell me that, it made me feel like or think that veggies are bad. And I think I needed to break out of that and really, you know, the rebel in me.
I think mom should cut that. You know, the preaching part of saying, eat your vegetables, finish your vegetables.
Yeah.
Maybe. Well, what worked for me is I just make something out of it so that my kids will have more of this.
Yeah, without having to say,
without having to
force them.
Yes, without having to force them.
So that helps.
So
you know,
that's how it went for our family.
Yeah. And now they love it. They crave it. They
yes.
look for it. So let's talk about how to introduce it. How to slowly do it. Or do you think it's better to go do it like just all out or just slowly introduce it?
I think it's a lifestyle that you really have to embrace.
Yeah.
And as I said, that it starts with the mindset. Mm-hmm. You know, a mindset of knowing that this would be good for my body.
Yeah.
This would be, this would give me much more energy. This would give me much more clarity. And once you know what it does to your body,
yeah,
then I think you'll naturally choose to have more of those than the ones that make you feel sick.
Yes, that's true.